हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग मामा जी। फाइनली
हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन, आई
गुड
थिंक।
मॉर्निंग मैम।
चलो
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
ओके। यस
रुपेश इज द
सर। यस यस
मोस्ट
मैम।
कंसिस्टेंट टाइप। हाउ आर यू रुपेश?
फाइन फाइन मैम, एब्सोल्युटली फाइन।
यू अटेंडेड द या यू अटेंडेड द यस्टरडे साउथर्न रीजन वेबिनार आल्सो?
यस 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 मैम। डीजे
वेरी
डीजे
गुड, आई वाज सो हैप्पी। या डीजे दीपक
या
जस्टिनियन,
Yeah,
हाउ डिड यू लाइक इट?
absolutely. I mean, it
डिड यू
was a good
लाइक
program.
इट?
Yeah, definitely, it was a good program
या
and stylish program, you can say. So,
एग्जैक्टली।
as a
एंड
trend.
द मोस्ट कैचिंग पॉइंट वाज, यू जस्ट टेल मी व्हाट वाज द मोस्ट कैचिंग पॉइंट?
मतलब as a trainer, we have to be, I mean, more, I mean, different kind of person and.
नो, फॉर अस एक्चुअली बीइंग अ स्टूडेंट, so we are very proud on the DJ actually, because he is the diploma student topper in his batch actually.
Ah,
He has
yes,
also
he told.
diploma courses, and
Yeah.
after that only he became the trainer, and he has risen so much into the training line in fact.
Right, right,
So
right.
that's what he was telling, because I think you have not joined from the beginning, no? You did not
No, no, no. From beginning, I
join
have
from the
joined.
beginning.
Yeah, definitely.
Achha. Okay. So
Madam, please go
Sudeep ji,
ahead.
how are you? You can
Fine.
share
I'm
your
good, ma'am.
PPT or other thing.
I'll take off.
This is the course review classes, and in the morning classes I was just expecting whether anybody will get connect or not, and at least two candidates are there. Most promptly Jitendra is also not there today. Isn't it? Chali, okay, you give me the host, no
He
problem,
must be coming.
let me speak.
Wow.
10 o'clock classes, I do understand in this winter. It's tough for the people to join.
More so on a Sunday.
Yeah, that's on Sunday. Let me wish you all, for the first time in the new year we are meeting. Let me
Happy
wish you
New
all
Year.
the very
Happy New Year.
happy
Happy
new
New
year.
Year.
Happy and safe. This
Yeah,
COVID 19 has troubled us so much last year. So we should have this safe year. Okay.
Madam, you are host and you can share a screen. I think take the class ahead. See you guys.
Okay.
12 o'clock.
Six participants are there. Okay. Rupesh, Arnav has joined and Upma has joined. Okay. Okay, so can you all see it out? What do this is the today is the course review new class. So who has done all the classes of mine? Unmute yourself, and today it should be interactive classes actually, because today is the course review classes, so it should be the interactive classes. What you have done, what I have taught, we should discuss it out about. Okay.
I missed one
yes.
session.
No.
I also missed one session only last.
Rupesh, you missed the last session, na? Otherwise, you were the most consistent student. Award should go to the Jitender. Rupesh, if I will be giving the most consistent student award, who has attended all the classes. Sudeep, you have also missed only one class.
Only one class.
Acha. Okay, then it's okay. So then, so you can interact us very very nicely actually. So. Who are not giving exams this year? You all are giving the exams?
Yes, sir.
Then good. Then it will be benefited today's classes for you people, in fact. So I'll start what we have done in six classes, I have taught in six classes. We'll be starting from the review from the session one. So session one, what we have done, overview of the training and opportunity and challenges for the training in the emerging business scenario. So one question I'm expecting, at least one question from this session should be there in the paper, opportunity and challenges for the training in the emerging business scenario or during the COVID-19 time. It may
Right.
be the question in your paper. Yeah, COVID-19 time also. So these you need to prepare it out. So overview of the training, you all know, because we are talking about the strategic training at the end, in fact, but the training when we talk about, so what is training? So you all know, we have told that what is the training? Training is the process of bridging the gap between the existing KSA and the
desired.
Yeah, desired KSA. Yes, either you can say desired or you can say the required KSA. Exactly. Training is the process of learning and unlearning. Training is the act of increasing the skills, knowledge, and abilities or competencies of an individual. We can say training, we can define it so different way. It is a highly useful tool that can bring the employee into a position where they can do their job more correctly, efficiently, and effectively. Training helps the employees in bringing the employee behavioral and attitudinal changes as well. So far the overview of the training we concept, and so far the scope, right now we can talk about the scope of the training. The scope is so very vast of the training, actually, because the scope, if we will be talking about in terms of the size of the company, whether the small company or the large company or the medium sized company is there, they all required the training. So far the private sector or the public sector, they all required training. Whether we talk about the new companies or the startups or the established company, all require. So scope of the training is very vast. Overview of the training, we are talking about the scope of the training. The scope of the training is very vast, actually. Whether the company is going for the diversification, they require the training. Whether the established companies are going for the expansion, they require the training. Whether they are going for the technological advancement, they require the training. So training scope is very vast. Whether they are going for the restructural of the organization, they require the training. So far the scope of the training is concerned, it's a very vast scope, and the every company should provide the training irrespective of the outlook, because you people are doing this course, actually, you need to understand the significance of the training, because every company should provide the training to all their employees, whether irrespective of the experience and the irrespective of their qualifications. If they want to, yes, if they want to thrive in the market, if they want to outplay their competitors, if they want to grow in the business, if they want to adapt the environmental changes, if they want to adapt the technological advancement, their training is required. Okay, because what do we say? That trained employees are real asset of any organization, and without them, no organization can achieve their goals and objectives. So scope of the training is very vast, and so for the importance of the training we talk about, it's a very vast training, because the field of training and development, in the first classes also I had told you people, actually training and development has undergone the dramatic improvement in recent times, actually, because especially with the inclusion of the computer and the websites and the technology, because the recent field of training and development is expanding the concept of learning beyond the learning of individual, or the group of the people should also learn, and the organization should also learn. In the first classes also I had told you that the learning organization and the knowledge management is fairly popular in the recent timing, actually, because not only individual employee needs to learn, the group of employees of the organization should also learn, and the organization should also learn. So concept of the, when we talk about the concept of the training, actually, so it has undergone improvement. Okay, so when we comes on the what importance we were talking about, so I had told you last time as one quote I had shown you that that has been given of the Nehru, the very, who can recall that quote? When significance of the training we were discussing in the first class, so now this is the revision classes is going on, so I'm not showing you, that's why you should recall it out. Who can tell me the significance, which quote, the very old quote of the Nehruji I have shown you that time, and that was so relevant, still relevant in present time also. What was that quote? Anybody can tell me? Anyone can tell me? No one? Are you people listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so can you tell me what was that quote actually to reflect the significance of the training? Because now the paper you need to give in the end of the month. Training is expensive. But without training, it is
more
expensive. I had shown you that quote that I mean the first session actually when we were talking about it. Warns of the dangers of the ignoring the training. Because many surveys have revealed that the companies who have loyalty of their employees invest heavily on the permanent training programs and promotion systems as well. So problem is that the many organizations see training as expenses, not as an investment. But if you people are going to work as a training professionals, you need to tell them the difference. Why the training is required? What are the advantages of the training? So when we talk about the advantages of the training, the first most important today, the companies are focusing on how to satisfy the employee. So how to make the employee happy? So training provide the personal development opportunity to the employees. They provide the growth opportunity to the employees. So it makes employees happy. And it's worth, what is said today, as on date, that it's worth to make employees happy because there is an actual correlation between the happy employees and successful employees and the successful business actually. So there is an actual correlation between the happy employees and successful employees, because if the employees are satisfied, if the employees are happy, they are retaining in the organizations and they are giving their 100%. And so it helps in achievement of the organization goal and objective. The first advantage is the most important, as and making the employee happy is a win-win situation for both. Okay. Secondly, training, what is the advantage of the training? Actually, second advantage is that training and retaining current employee is cheaper. Training and retaining of the current employee is cheaper than hiring the new. This is the advantage, because without lack of training, what is happening? The company who are not focusing and appreciated, they are unhappy in their job. And what is the long run? They used to, in the long run, they are leaving the job. That's what we had discussed actually, retaining the to train and retain the current employees is cheaper affair. It's an economical affair than hiring the new employees. So this is the another advantage of the training actually. Another advantages we talk about, then train employees work smarter. So that you all must be understanding. When we used to give the training, then what is happening actually, proper training makes workers better and more capable of their job. They perform their job more efficiently and it saves the time of the company. So time is money. So the advantages. Okay, so when we talk about the objectives, because we are doing the revision rounds, so I'm just session one, what we did, I'm just explaining you all the roles. When we talk about the roles of the training and development, it increases the efficiency, it improves job performance, it increases the morale of the employees, it reduces the supervision. This is the such a bit of advantage. So this is the role of better human relationship. This is the role of the training and development. It increases the organizational flexibility. So development is also in the changing organizational scenario actually, as a process needs to keep evolving. We cannot say ki whatever, because as per the, because the training strategy we have already talked, because now the all the course chapters we have done it out, all the we have covered almost the this paper one, business strategy and HRD. So you might have understood by this time actually ki training, it needs to be evolving in the organization as per the need also. So roles of training and development is changing in organizational scenario as the process needs to keep evolving with the evolving business environment. Business is changing, environment is changing, so training also needs to be keep evolving. Organization can adapt to the changing environment workplace scenario only by continuously revising, improving and modifying their training and development plans. So advantages, these are the advantages classes, what is happening actually. So productivity, it lowers the productivity, it decreases the efficiency of the employees, it deteriorates the job performance, it employee gets dissatisfied, employee is unhappy, then they are not productive, lower productivity. So many advantages the company who are not providing, if they are not looking for the trained and efficient employee who can work effectively, who can contribute to the growth of the organizations, then they didn't require the training. So the advantage, there are so many advantages of the training. Secondly, the major things which I was discussing, opportunity and challenges for the training in the emerging business scenario. Very, very important part, opportunity and challenges for training in the emerging business scenario. So first opportunity I had told was the globalization. So globalization has brought the diversity of the workforce diversity, and workforce diversity has brought the cultural diversity. And to address this issue, the training is required. From the orientation and onboarding, the training is required. Which training? Orientation and induction training is required. The onboarding, which we used to call these days. Then the cross-cultural understanding training is required. The English language, the common language is the English. So English language communication skill is required. So training is, globalization is one of the greater opportunity which has brought the ample of opportunity for the training. Second, we had discussed in the emerging business scenario, the second opportunity has been brought by the changing environment, the environmental changes. These, the mechanization, computerization, the automations have resulted in many changes at the workplace actually. And that requires trained staff, okay, who are possessing the enough skills. And here falls the opportunity for the training. Third opportunity we had discussed about was the organizational complexity. What do we mean the organizational complexity? Because with the modern invention, the technological advancement, upgradations, the expansions, diversifications had made the business so complex actually. The business to different segment or different product line, organization have become very complex right now actually. Just for the survival, they are diversifying their businesses actually. From one portfolio, if they are not getting the money, then from the another business, another portfolio, they will be getting the business. So it has made the organization, the big organization, very complex actually, and which had aggravated the problem of coordination. Serious coordination problem is there into these organization actually. To cope up with the complexity, training has become mandatory right now. Okay, in the bigger organizations, the organization, larger organization with the multiple units, and so coordination problem has become so seriously actually the problematic. So to cope up with this complexity, training is required. So this is the another opportunity of the training. Then the next opportunity has been brought by the talent shortage of talent, right? Because of these complexity has given the contributed to the shortage of talent actually. Every so much advancement is coming actually, the existing employees are not able to cope it up with it. So they are not having the advanced knowledge of that field. Technical advancement is so much going on and actually. So shortage of talent when we talk about the technical companies, so they are always having this shortage of talent because the techniques are changing so fast actually. And that is a problem. So all above reasons, we can say it out. Even globalization, the environmental changes, and these have contributed actually to the shortage of talent in the market or in the organization. So in the level of skill required, the kind of expertise required is not available in the market right now. So big firms, as I told you, like a Deloitte, KPMG, are struggling with the issue, such scenario actually. So there is always a gap between the present employee organizational requirement. And to fill this gap, training is required. Okay. So another, this is the one of the opportunity where the training falls. The shortage of talent is always with the company. So you people being training professional, so there is a ample of a scope to fill this gap. Okay. So another, human relations we have talked about. It's very, very important. The companies are so seriously focusing on maintaining the good relations employee. So companies are working on employee relation. Companies are working on employee engagement just to control the rate of attrition, just to improve the rate of retentions. They are so much focusing on that. And to make the employee happy, they need to provide the training. Because right now, employees are not working for the job. They are looking for the career. So they require the career planning, succession planning, they require these things into the company. So training is so very important for that actually, how to upgrade the employees in fact. Okay, so another important opportunity is brought by the change of assignment. So change of assignment when the employees are getting promoted or when they are getting transferred to just required to adapt to the new change positions, they require the training. So higher positions, because when existing employees are promoted to higher positions or transfer to another department or other place, then training is required to equip them with the new responsibility, we can say. So these are the advantages. These are the relationship organizations are looking to maintain the good relationship with the employee relation. You can say it on employee relation with the companies are working, employee engagement, the companies are opportunity, both the sides are facing. Employees are facing the problem actually, the organizations are also facing the problem actually, because the scenario has been changed so much. Work from home has become so tough right now for the. So these are the opportunity which brought the bring the opportunity also. So when we talk about the challenges actually, so what are the challenges? Opportunity in terms of the COVID-19 time, if I'll be talking it about. Anybody can tell me what are the COVID-19 has brought the opportunities? Anyone can tell me?
Challenges or pandemic challenges?
Opportunity. Training opportunity. Yeah, in the COVID-19 time. Actually, in industrial terms, you tell me which industries are what did so much scope of the training in fact in the COVID-19.
I mean, software industries. I mean, all software development industries are
because of.
Digitalization. Yeah, the training is required.
Digitalization is the word actually, because so you required what in which industry I told you by because of the hospital industry has got the ample because the manpower surplus manpower they required actually. They required the ample of manpower to cater to the patients. So COVID-19 time has brought, when we talk about the industrial terms, not all hospitality industry, the hospitality industry, if I'll talk about the hotel industry has faced the then I don't think what problem that they have faced with the hotel industry. We will talk about the insurance companies and all restaurant business, catering business. They have faced so much challenges and the problem into the market in the COVID-19 time. But the probability had been brought when we talk about the opportunity in the medical, the hospital industry, medical, paramedical, medical. So frontlining, police, so much opportunity was there actually. They were bringing from the medical college the student, the final year student to cater to this industry. And they were giving the training and they were deploying them to serve the nation. So these are COVID-19 time has brought the opportunity for these industry. In fact, the challenges, when we talk about the challenges, the common challenges in the emerging business scenario is the hectic employee schedule. We had discussed in the first session also. Hectic employee schedule, these the employees are not feeling like taking the employee because they are so much problems in the personal front and then the facing they are facing. In. So what is happening in present scenario? The hectic work schedule, the family life and other personal problems are draining the employees' energy actually. And so much that there is a risk that training just adds to their stress. To deal with this is very challenging actually. And we had discussed in the first classes also, first session also, okay, what are the solution to deal with this challenge? Only knowing the challenges will not do. We need to be training professional. You are doing this course actually to understand it out, how to deal, what are the solution to deal with the challenges. So anybody can tell me what is the solution? We have discussed in the first session in such a elaborate manner. What are the solution to deal with the hectic employee schedule? Employees are not feeling like taking the training. So they're having so much problem to deal with this. Is very challenging, actually very challenging to make them sit in the training hall and the training room and to give them training. So what is the solution for that? Tell me. These things only is the practical things you need, people need to understand. So what is the solution? They only, you can walk in the either in the company or tell me. This is the practical things you need to understand.
Actually, this pandemic
which
time
of training.
Employee engagement.
Not only the pandemic time actually, because this is the question is the emerging business scenario. Globalization has brought so much and environmental changes is going on. So hectic employee schedule is the multinational company. What do you think actually? If they're paying you, they are taking 100% of yours.
Yeah, definitely.
So employees are so exhausted. Employees are so dead actually. Just to save their job actually. Job is so insecure to the company because they are looking for the performers. They are not looking for the non-performers.
Right.
So there's so much stress of the employees' life right now. To how to deal with it and being training professional. What is the solution? What is the solution? We had discussed it out in very, very how to provide the training. What you will be doing as a training professional? First, we had discussed what should be the approach, the micro learning approach. You people should consider micro learning approach. You should wait. This is the very important thing, solution you need to understand it out. Deliver useful and relevant content in bite-sized chunks. Because use the short videos. You can see it out right now. How much is going on in the actually COVID-19 time also. We are catching all the information through the short videos, the webinars, infographic, getting it out of the GIFs format to
Madam,
make the training easier. Hello?
Excuse me, sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
I think your slides are not showing.
I need to. No, I'm not showing the slides actually. Because what topics are there, I'm not showing the slides actually.
Same slide is going
you
on.
You want me to?
Only session one is I mean,
what we have reviewing. Done actually, the topic, I'm revising it out.
Ajay, sorry.
You want me to show the slides also?
No, it's okay. Please go ahead.
The major topics we need to revise, we have taught in elaborate manner, Babaji, in the session already. Today is the course review to all the six sessions I need to wrap up.
Understood. So, I thought you are talking and that slide is not transferring.
I'm just revising, giving them
really. Yeah, yeah.
I don't think you people are requiring.
No. Already we have.
Yeah, they need to revise. They need to recall actually because they'll have to give exams in the end of the month. That's why I'm not showing it out right now to them. They must be having. If you're requiring, then tell me clearly right now. Then I'll be showing the total PPTs. Is it required?
Not needed, ma'am.
No, ma'am. I don't think so.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Okay, then the hectic schedule we were talking about how to deal with the micro learning approach, the fast, I'll be moving it out. This is the most important actually, I think one question maybe from this thing actually, this paper, coming paper. So short videos, you can use it out. The webinars is going on, the checklist, infographics and the GIFs formats you need to optimize your training to, most important right now, optimize your training to the mobile.
Mobile
features these days allow learners to access the LMS and training method material from anywhere, any time. Okay, the other thing you need to, the first challenges, second challenges we had discussed in that time was the dispersed workforce right now.
Diverse
companies workforce. Are large companies are having their multiple units, exactly. And the employees and the candidates are available at different locations. So what is the solution? Now you tell me. Solution, people need to tell me, being training professional, you're going to do the training, PG diploma in training.
Yeah, the training must be customized as per the requirement of the level of the employees and function of the employees as per their requirement.
So this first workforce, decentralized workforce has led the new challenges in training and development actually. To be the workforce at different locations and with different culture, training can be quite tough and hard. So what is the solution for that actually? Use social tools to unify your dispersed team. For example, I had told you that I'm also the video conferencing, the webinars, online forums are easy and convenient tools to provide the training. And the most importantly, we had told that time also to clarify the training goals. If you want to make it effective, actually, the training, sitting the audience, the participants are sitting at the various places, actually. So clarify the training goals clearly from the start to all the team members who are present to different locations. And the second most important thing, implement the training agreement online.
Yes, ma'am.
Outlining the expectations of and just tell them, they convey them the expectations of the organizations and ask all the learners to sign it as a commitment to the learning process. Otherwise, they will not be transferring that knowledge to their jobs. That is the problem, because the most important challenges, that's why why the training strategy had come in picture actually. The training in the strategy, because to link the training with the So that training should not go sheer waste actually. We are aligning the training with the business strategy. Why? Because one of the reasons, because just to make the employee understand how their individual performance is affecting the organizational performance. So that they should be learning better and they should be transferring their learning to their current job actually. Otherwise, there is a sheer benefit and this is only the cost liability on the company actually. So being training professional, we need to understand it out, how to take the commitment of the learners actually. So training agreement should get it signed by them, make it signed by them in fact. And just clarify all the training goals to them, what is the purpose of organization to conduct this training. Okay. Then another challenges was the different learning habits. Different learning habits we had discussed, because the current in the company right now, in the presently, the three generations are working, the generation X, Y, and Z. Three generations are working in the company and all are having the different
mindset,
learning habits.
Learning habits.
different mindset, different learning habits, different relationship with technology. So deal with this is the quite challenging right now into the multinational company. So yeah, I mean, since the three generations are working actually, and to deal with them is a for provide as a training professional, it's quite challenging. So what is the solution for that? Can you recall what are the solution for that?
Yeah, methodology definitely should be different for different generations.
So which methodology? That's what I'm asking.
Because like Generation Z, I mean, we can use, I mean, social.
Solution can. What is the solution? How to deal with this challenge? We need to all. At first, you need to be carried very thoroughly into the organization and identify the learners' preferences, especially in relation to technology. Okay, and then decide the and then design the training. And then decide the methodology, by which methodology we should deliver the training actually. So secondly, choose the software with a simple user interface. UI should be simple. And the most important is what the most of the company, doing successful companies are doing right now. They are opening up the communication channel right now. YouTube channel, you can see it out. So many companies are having actually right now. Getting it out. So this is the one of the advantage. Then use tools like discussion forum to make it easy for all learners to use questions and receive both content and technical guidance. So communication, you can open up the communication channel, and the most important thing is before conducting the training, actually thorough the training need analysis, TNA should be done, and you need to identify the learner's preferences first and then provide the training. Don't impose the training. Okay. And then another challenges was the lack of engagement, as I told, because engagement is very important at the three levels, cognitive level, emotional level, and the behavioral level. So all the three levels, the lack of engagement leads to poor knowledge retention. So that why the lack of engagement is also very challenging. How to engage the employee at all the three levels for the good learning retention. So solution for that is also incorporate practical learning activities, case studies, scenarios, role play. Getting it out?
Yeah.
These are the solution actually. Yeah. So incorporate practical learning activities in just to deal with these challenges. Okay. So these are the major challenges which you people will be facing it out. And in the company, the existing company, established company, there are some established training also, the regular training also, which are given to all the employees, which are not relevant for all the employees. So that is also very challenging training that isn't relevant actually. So solution for that actually, don't make it the essential training, but all the training compulsory. Only make essential training compulsory. And then if you want to engage the employee, the audience, then use the gamification. Here falls the, just to engage the employees, gamification falls in picture actually. Gamification through the rewards, badges, points, encourage learners. And make it interesting through the gamifications actually. Management games are so much going on right now in the company. For giving the team building, so we are making them play. Okay, and the one important solution is the leverage the just-in-time training. Just-in-time training is so much in picture right now. To update the skills or convey new information exactly when it's needed. When they are needed, just in time. That time only they design the training and conduct the training actually. Okay. So these are the major things in the session. One, we had discussed it out. The overview of the training, what is training, and the opportunity and challenges of the training. So next session was the organizational strategy. What is organizational strategy? Why organizational strategy is required? Why the company is requiring the strategic planning? Why? What are the features? So this is a very important. So many questions we are expecting from this chapter actually. So many, I think designing part also, the part two, which is carrying the case studies. So one question will be definitely for the designing the, developing the models of strategic planning for the organization. This should be the one question, the part B, definitely there should be the question. So we were discussing this session two actually, what is organization strategy? Anybody can recall? What is it? What is the organization strategy? Who can tell me? What is it? You really want me to show the slides? Or recall? What is organizational strategy? I told you, it is a top management game plan to succeed in business. So organizational strategy is actually the roadmap for the company. From vision to goal, goal to plans, plans to action, action to success.
Success.
I think you people are requiring the should I show this slides?
No.
Is it required? Tell me fast.
Yes.
It's okay. You have now?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So organizational strategy is the top management game plan. Yeah. Okay, to succeed in business, it is the roadmap of the organization from vision to goal, goal to plans, plans to action, and action to success. It is the set of management decisions. It is the set of, it's a long-term plan actually. The strategic planning, this is the long-term plan company, which maps the routes, towards realization of a company's goals and objective actually. Okay, so when we talk about the, because as a whole, because it includes the environmental scanning, strategy formulation, strategy implementation, strategy evaluation and control. And as a whole, we call it strategic planning of the company. So organizational strategy as a whole is known as strategic planning of the company. And the strategic planning takes at least years time to complete. And it requires the involvement from all the levels of the people of the organizations. I mean, top management, actually, you need to understand it out, because I had told you in the second session also, actually, who creates the strategic planning? Top management creates the larger organizational strategy. So top management commitment is so very important for strategic planning, actually. So top management creates the larger picture of the strategy, while middle level and the lower level of management adopt the goals and plans to fulfill the overall strategy step by step. Okay, so why organizational strategy is required? Because it sets the direction and power. The second topic was why company needs the strategic planning. So you people need to understand why it is needed, because it sets direction and priorities for your business. It gives business direction or a roadmap. Okay. It gives business consistency. It improves performance of the consistency, so that it will improve the performance of the organization. They're having the clear roadmap. So when there is no roadmap, we are directionless, then they are not achieving anything actually. So strategic planning, it is said actually, if you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. In the company who are failing to plan, then they are planning to fail. And that's why the strategic planning is so very, so what it clarifies, another reason why it is required actually, because it is aligning the teams and department in one common goal. It is unifying the goals actually. It is aligning teams, department, or organization in one common goal. It clarifies and simplifies decision making. It allows your business to adapt to the environmental changes. So these are the why it is required, what is organizational strategy. I had told you why it is required. You need to understand features. We had next is the features. Features we have discussed. There's the four key features of the strategic planning. Anyone can recall?
Yeah, realistic, measurable, specific, and time bound.
What are the key features of the? Or, very, very, very.
Four very features are realistic, measurable, specific, and time bound.
For the successful strategic planning, should be very good. Okay, so I need not to tell major components of strategic planning. Who can tell me? Next is major components. We should move fast. Half an hour is left. What is the major components,
ma'am, like mission, vision, planning, goals, objective, initiatives, measurement, like.
Very rightly. So because all the components you need to understand, major components of the strategic planning is mission, vision, goal, objective, initiative,
measures,
and targets. These are the major components of the strategic planning. Then next is level of organizational strategy. Measures, we are discussing about the measures actually. The business indicators are to monitor the success of the business. The indicators we are using is the lag indicators and the lead indicators. We have always discussed about this. What are the level of organizational strategy?
Three levels, ma'am. Corporate strategy, business strategy, and functional strategy.
Anyone can recall? Three levels.
Yes. Three levels. Corporate, business, and functional.
Very, very rightly said. So three level, the corporate organization. Yes. So at what is the decisions we are taking at the corporate level? Corporate level, top management is taking the decisions related to the
complete business. Whether and whole
the
business.
Whether corporate level will the company will be going for the whole business, whether the company will be going for the acquisition, whether the company will be going for the diversification, or they will be going for the restructuring, and whether they are going for the retrenchment, which is COVID-19 time, retrenchment and right sizing, so much in market in the COVID-19. So these are the main corporate level. What decisions are taken? Business level is very important because we are aligning the HR, we talk about the three strategy, organization strategy, training strategy, and then talk about the strategy. That means we are linking HR strategy means we need to align the HR with the business strategy. When we talk about the training strategy, that means we need to align the training with the business strategy. So business strategy level is very important actually.
It's a tactics to beat the competition.
In the market, that it should be sold, which is the viable market. Yeah, because and for that only it is decided that with that or the whatever product or service which might be sold. So what are the customers, which customers, and the third layer function level, day to day that is taken at the functional level. So these are three levels. Then we need how many steps we are following for the process of strategic planning?
Ma'am, if you can show the slides now onwards, Seema ma'am, if you can show the slides now, it will also help.
Okay, let me try.
there are four steps we have discussed.
Hmm. Achha, you have opened it out? You have the slides?
No, sir. No, ma'am. I have made
Achha,
a note.
You have written?
Made a note for that.
Okay. So I'll have to go to the stop. Okay, you can see it out now. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Is it visible? Hello.
Yes, it is visible.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Visible, ma'am.
Visible.
Yeah. Okay. People are not saying. So you can see it out now. Map for the organization: from vision to goal, goals to plan, plan to action, action to success. So it is a top management game plan to succeed in business. Next, we had already discussed it out. What is why organizational strategy is needed? We have already discussed features of the organization strategy. There are four key features that already the page had.
Why organization?
Told level of strategy. You can see it out. At the three level, the strategy is formulated: corporate level, business. Discussed what are the major components? Yeah, mission, vision, goals, objective, initiative, measures, and targets. Mission means what is the purpose? Why the company is in business actually? What is the reason of existence of the company? In fact, is decided the mission. Vision is the what we want to be, where we want to reach. What actually the vision is the aspiration of the business. What is the purpose to be in business actually is the vision. Goals, what we must achieve to be successful. Objective is all about achieving the goals. The specific outcomes expressed in measurable terms. Initiatives are plans of action. For each objective actually, there should be one initiative. And to support the initiative, there is always a plan of action actually to support it out. And to achieve the initiative, measures should be there. Measure means indicators and monitor to success. Targets. So what is the target? It is the desired level of performance with the timelines. So these are the major component of the process we were discussing. So there are the four steps for the processing, the developing the strategic planning. Step one is setting up of strategic intent. That is, you need to develop the mission statement, vision statement, goals, and objective. In writing, it is documented, and then only it provides the roadmap. Okay, step two, strategy formulation should be there. So strategy formulation is a very important step actually. So it involves the assessment part, where the company is right now and where they want to be. So environmental scanning is required, environmental appraisal is required at this stage. SWOT analysis is done. The resource analysis is done at this step. So designing part also we'll be discussing. It is including the environmental appraisal as well as the organizational appraisal. So companies are identifying what are the strength point and the sort is weaknesses of the company and what are the threats and opportunities. Strategy implementation. The step which is the action stage. So activation of the strategy is done at this stage, in fact, which is the most crucial. Always the implementation is most crucial. And so at this stage, you need to implement all behavioral implementation, functional implementation, operational implementation, then the structure, designing of the structure, processes, systems, everything is implemented, and then step four will be strategy, evaluation, and control. You need to monitor it out. You need to evaluate the performances. What is the difference between the actual and planned?
Required, yeah.
Okay, so it is actual versus planned. So that is the evaluation criteria is done. So these are the process of strategic planning. Ab ye dekhe, these process you need to follow when the you are doing the case studies also. I'll be showing you the designing of the paper, then I'll be discussing it out. That's why the steps, the process of the strategic planning, process of training strategy, process of the HR strategy is very important to learn for the dealing with the paper actually. Okay. Examples of the mission is this is not today important. Various models, examples, I think we had examples of this. No. These are various models of the strategic planning process. Very important part, various model is related. A question jarur aap log ka aane wala hai, like what are the various models of the strategic planning actually. So different, so many different models we had talked about.
The basic model,
I also required the charger. Just give me a sec. My battery, who is coinciding mine?
Seema, I'm sorry.
Because my also reflecting your battery is running low.
I didn't realize my audio also was off.
Okay. Hello. Yes. Sorry. So I have also taken the charges. Thank you for giving me this timing. Thought I also took it out. Okay. So models we were discussing there, the various models of the organization strategy planning, the basic model issue. Basic issue model is the अभी देखिए आपका पार्ट टू में द केस स्टडी क्वेश्चंस विल बी कमिंग एक्चुअली द साइज ऑफ द कंपनी मैटर्स इफ द बेसिक मॉडल इज एक्चुअली एप्रोप्रिएट फॉर द व्हिच कंपनीज बेसिक मॉडल इज रिक्वायर्ड अब इफ यू आर हैविंग द केस स्टडी रिलेटेड टू हू हैव नॉट डन एनी प्रोजेक्ट बिफोर एक्चुअली द बेसिक मॉडल इज एक्चुअली एप्रोप्रिएट फॉर द स्मॉलर कंपनी एक्चुअली आइडेंटिफाई द पर्पस आइडेंटिफाई स्पेसिफिक अप्रोच एंड स्ट्रेटजी आइडेंटिफाई प्लान्स टू अचीव द स्ट्रेटजी एंड देन मॉनिटर इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ द प्लानिंग सो दैट इज मोर देन एनफ फॉर द स्मॉल कंपनी और द स्टार्टअप कंपनी एक्चुअली हू हैज नॉट डन द प्रोजेक्ट सो दे sizes of the company matter for planning strategy. If you are doing this strategic planning in the company, the size of the company matters actually. Okay, this issue based model or we are calling it goal based model. So goal based model is good for the established company actually. So these are the, because I cannot go in detail, so alignment model alignment model, actually strategic model, is important for those companies who are struggling from internal problems, where there is a poor alignment of the strategic planning is there. There, in such cases, you can adopt the alignment strategic model, actually. Because in the three cases, actually, the strategic planning is required. The first, where there is no existing need to plan. Second, the strategic planning is in existence, but it is ineffective. So you need to improve the strategic planning. The third case is strategic planning is in picture. It's working also so successfully, but in some part it is ineffective. So there also the scenario based and the goal, we can make it out. So alignment the strategic model is important for such companies actually who are having the strategic planning, but they are having the internal business, internal serious internal problems. Okay, so they're struggling from the internal problems. So poor alignment of the strategic planning is there. So that's suggested. Another model is scenario based model. Okay, so particular scenario you will be this plan developing the planning. Organic model. Other model, which is very important model we have discussed, is the blue ocean strategy, which is so much in picture right now. So don't new product, new service, red ocean strategy. I had told the market strategy where the saturated market is there. So many companies are in the market. So saturation is there. The cutthroat competition is there. That is called the red ocean. And the blue ocean where there is no competition. So think for the innovative product, innovative services, innovative ideas should be having. So innovation and creativity is so much in picture because of that. This is the one.
Hello, good morning. Are you guys there?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
How are things, Atul?
Yes, sir. Things are pretty good. Thank you. Preparing for exams.
Preparing for exam. I think morning we discussed before I think you came. Exams are on which are the dates?
31st, 5th and 6th.
5th and 6th, correct. P1 to P4.
Yeah.
Paper 1 to paper 4. So 4 days.
Yeah. Earlier, according to the previous date sheet, it was supposed to be 27, 28, 29, 30.
Right. Now it will be.
In fact, I applied for leaves according to that. I'll change, you know, maybe.
What are you telling?
The thing, I applied for leaves in my office according to that.
Okay.
So I will change.
Yeah, that's right. Especially those who have the working on those days.
Huh? Yeah.
Thirty-first is Saturday, Sunday.
That is fine.
And that is
that's fine. An off already.
Then 5th, 6th is supposed to be Friday and Saturday.
Yeah.
So, anybody, so you all are appearing exam? Anybody is not able to appear? No.
I'm sure everybody is giving exams.
Have you got some information regarding the mock test or something?
In last classes, it was talked about that there's going to be a mock test, but I don't know when is it.
There is no information as such.
Okay. No, last class means I only was mentioning as
well. Yeah, you mentioned, sir.
Some other class. No, we have got the confirmation of the dates, but I think mock test dates are not yet given. But okay. I think it may come in a day or two. So I will intimate you as and when it comes.
Sure, sir.
Fine.
So we may have some mock test, basically, because the online exam certainly new for everyone, including you, all the students, plus organizer, host, admin. So we have to get used to. So I always insist you must attend those mock tests and see how things works. And then in the morning, as we were discussing, even for I knew about two options which I discussed, the exams which will be conducted basically in a form like you will get a page and where you can type your answers. So that is the one way of doing. And second, you can write on pages and then scan it and then load it. So, but these two way I always tell people, you have to decide which is the best suitable for you. Because you know yourself much better than anybody else. So you have to decide whether you would like to sit and type or you like to write. So you have to see in which way you are efficient so that you can choose the efficient way of doing things and then appear for exam, right?
Mm-hmm.
And one more. Rupesh Rai.
Yes, sir. No, some procession is going on, sir. Ram Mandir, so it was very.
Volume thoda kam kar do. Madam has come. Madam is coming. So now,
hello. Yeah, I'm so sorry. The Wi-Fi has gone. It got disconnected. Vama ji?
Please.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay. I'm still host. No,
I was just talking to them regarding exams, and then.
Okay. You have already explained them the exams and the way of the paper, about the paper?
Yes. 2-3 ways which we have specified about the dates as well as the type, the way exam will be conducted. I've explained.
Achha, the way exam will be conducted, you have already explained it out?
Yes, I have explained.
Okay.
Okay, you can proceed.
Okay.
You have just.
Okay, because. Yeah, okay. Give me the host.
Huh.
10-15 minutes, I'll be taking only 15-20 minutes. Let me move fast. Give me host.
Yeah. Please proceed.
Yeah, thank you. Yes. Okay. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so sorry. Actually, today also the interruption is so much. So we were talking about the model.
Your voice is cracking, ma'am.
Hello.
Getting your voice properly, actually.
Am I audible?
No, ma'am. It's cracking.
Because I cannot do anything. There is a networking issue. Net connection is having the problem right there. Can I move? Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible to me right now.
I also cannot hear you people. Yeah. Okay. So other models will be talking about. Now I'll be moving for the designing part actually. The designing of a strategic planning process model, which is a very common model, is whenever the question comes, can you develop the strategic planning model for the organization, then you can follow this ABCDE model actually. So whenever you're designing the model, there are strategic model is actually for the basis of components, the down to and for evaluation. So in the component, we have the process of planning, we have talked about this part to do the Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Oh, so much problem is there. Can you see the screen now?
No, ma'am. Not yet.
No. Oh. Can you see now?
No, ma'am, not
no,
yet.
No, no.
Why it's not coming? I'm doing the slideshow. You people are not able to show? See it out?
No, ma'am.
It's still not visible?
No, ma'am.
I think you might have lost the host. God.
What is happening?
No, host is not important.
Oh, okay.
Madam, you can still show slides.
Yeah.
It should come.
No, I'm showing it out there. But it's not coming. They're saying that I'm showing it out. I believe. Vamaji?
Uh-huh.
Can you check it out?
I'll transfer the host, but it should have come. Actually.
Yes, sir, it does not matter.
It does not matter because I have kept a multiple participants slide. There is an option in that.
Host now. It is showing now. You are the host now.
To you.
Is it going right now?
No, ma'am.
No. I don't know what is happening.
Host was not the issue. Some other issue is.
It's not coming? Still not coming? Hello?
No, no.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Presently, it is
some
not.
Other issue. Why is it not coming? Slideshow from big. I'm not understanding. Just a moment. Just give me time. So cool.
So, gentlemen, I was talking about this exam. Na? Yeah, it's coming now.
Yes, ma'am. Now we can see this.
It's coming now?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And sorry for the inconvenience to all of you. Okay, so I was showing the designing part actually. So ABCD, whenever you are designing the strategic planning model, actually, you can follow this ABCDE model actually. Okay, so I move the assessment B for best president, future of the company. Then significant issue, identify the significant issues, and then align it out and identify the gaps. I choose the baseline. Where we are. First question you need to ask, where the company is right now. And then where we want to go for that component, that mission, with the goals, objective statement in black and white. You need to document it out, you need to develop it out. What is the purpose of cooking business? What and why this? Then goals and objectives will develop. Then how we add it down specific. So down spend will be coming in measure and targets. Then how relationships, this I will not go actually. Now the third will be the, just a moment. The third session will be, we had done a, hello. Just mute yourself, who is talking right now, because I don't have the, frequent disconnection actually. Can you see it? Hello?
No, ma'am, your screen you that you were...
Such a please connect.
No, no, ma'am, you have to share it again.
Big class, hello.
Such a frequent disconnection.
Oh, the bike. My thing. Okay.
Sorry?
I think आपका स्पीच भी कट रहा है. हेलो
हेलो हेलो Hello.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Yeah, it's still not visible, the screen?
No, ma'am, the screen is not visible, but you are audible now.
Again, such a frequent disconnection is happening actually. Okay, I'm audible and the screen is not visible. So should I move like audible? Yeah. Now, Amaji, what is your suggestion?
मैं मुझे लगता है कि आपको शायद स्क्रीन
दोबारा शेयर करनी पड़ेगी. अच्छा ओके ओके अच्छा ओके जस्ट गिव मी 5 मिनट्स लेट मी ट्राई.
Madam, you are trying sharing the PPT or something?
Can you see it out? Hello?
Yes, ma'am, your screen is visible.
Can you see the screen?
Yes, there is a folder with different presentations in it.
Hello? Hello. It's visible now. Okay.
Presentation now, Manish.
No, that's why I wanted to get it now. I'm running this short of time actually. In the final, I will pick only the business started. We did give half an hour, but much I'll be finishing it out. This is started and the human. So putting the key that is important part actually is strategy is the business overall plan for managing its human capital to give actually HR this alignment is important because this provides the roadmap to the big company to leverage its human capital as a competitive advantage actually. So HR strategy key key framework when we will talk about, then I had discussed it. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes,
ma'am. Such a frequent disconnection is happening actually. I'm not able.